You may be the first Secretary of Defense who looks at a shrinking Defense Department budget. How does that make your job?
It becomes another part of the challenge. How do you face your responsibility to provide for the national security of this country, and at the same time try to meet the fiscal requirements that that the country is facing? I don't think you have to choose. I've said this a number of times. I don't think you have to choose between our fiscal security and our national security. Clearly, we are facing a crisis because of these huge deficits that the country is facing. And clearly, defense is going to have to play a role in trying to achieve whatever savings we can achieve without undermining our national defense and our national strength. That's going to be the challenge. How do I achieve savings? How do I try to implement efficiencies and at the same time make sure that we protect the strongest and finest military force in the world? I think there are ways to do it. Obviously, the Congress and the President signed off on an initial set of savings that we're going to have to implement. And
$400 billion
Something like $400 billion over 12 years. And I'm working with the service chiefs. I'm working with all of our staffs within the Pentagon to kind of say, okay, how can we do this in a way that obviously implements efficiencies, implements reforms, but creates a national defense that not only protects us today, but will protect us in 5 to 10 years down the road. So I think we have to establish a vision about where we want our national defense to be and be able to get there. It's going to have to be more agile. It's going to have to be more flexible. We're going to have to quickly deploy those forces. We're going to have the kind of weaponry that will assist them in that effort. We're going to have to achieve better efficiencies in procurement as well as in other management areas. And at the same time, we're going to have to protect our commitment to the troops and their families, because at the heart of our national defense system is a volunteer force. So we've got to be able to do all of this without breaking faith with those that put their lives on the line ultimately and really are the ones who are the key to whether or not our defense system works or not.
Join us online at charlierose.com.